right now we have enough structure to talk about preference of a person, or and then by combining that we have already learned that the budget set, by combining these two a person can make a choice. But it's sometimes it's a good idea, because we observe certain regularity in the world, in humans behave, in humans preferences. So we are going to learn about them also and how it would change the problem. I'm not saying if these are less important in a way, but it helps us immensely mathematically. That's why we are going to learn some more, if you want to call them, you should call them psychological assumption about human behavior. Okay? And the first of those is non-satiation. Non-satiation. What does it mean, non-satiation? It simply means, simple translation would be never satisfied, never satisfied. And it has two forms. Okay? There are two different forms of non-satiation that we are going to learn. I'm not saying that these are true all the time, but these are true most of the time. And when these are true, our problem becomes much simpler, okay, to solve. So the first form is more is better. So whatever you have, let's say in two good world, okay, in two good world, you have a bundle here, let's say it is 2, 2, any bundle which has at least more of one of these two goods would be preferred over this bundle. That's what it says, that more is better. So in other word, we can say, we can take like this, okay, and whatever we have here would be preferred over 2, 2. Or in other word, whatever we have here, we get is strictly better than 2, 2. And then here, well, whatever you take here, clearly you would prefer that, whichever bundle you take from this zone, you will prefer 2, 2 over that particular bundle, because 2, 2 has at least more of one of these two items. Okay? So that's what we figure out, and that is more is better. Math in economics jargon, it is called monotonicity. Mathematically speaking, x is preferred to y if x is greater than or equal to y with at least one x I, is greater than y I. Fine? This is monotonicity. It is clear? Can you think of any other version of being never satisfied? Have you ever heard term called envy? Envy? Whatever you are whatever you have, you are not happy about it. You want something different, not necessarily something more. What you want, what your neighbor has, in one way to put it. So that's called local non-satiation. And what does it mean? Dissatisfaction, of course, this is the technical term, local non-satiation, as the technical term here is monotonicity. What it means is that dissatisfaction with the current bundle in your consideration. Mathematically speaking, it's a bit technical in a way that you take a bundle here x, you take a bundle here x and take a small region that is close to x. Of course, if I, there can be more stringent mathematical definition, but we are not getting into it. So, what we have? We are talking about different bundles which are very similar to x. So, when no matter how small zone, how small region we take, we always find a bundle in that zone that you prefer over x. Let us say this zone is called neighborhood of x. Okay. So, there exists a y in neighborhood of x and y is of course, not x, but you prefer y over x. Whatever you have, you do not like, you want something different basically, you want something different. Do you understand? You did not understand. Okay. So, for example, let me give you more one more example here. Let us take here good 1 and here we have good 2. Good 1 can be food, good 2 can be cloth and here we are taking 2, 1. If we take a small zone, small region near 2, 1, what kind of good we get? Either we will get 2 plus epsilon, 1 plus epsilon, where epsilon is some small number, okay? Or we will get 2 minus epsilon, 1 plus epsilon, okay? Or we will get 2 minus epsilon, 1 minus epsilon, and of course, epsilon can have different value because we are taking a zone. So, what we are saying then, that one of these elements would be preferred over 2, 1 by you, because that bundle is different. So, here this is simple, that you are unhappy with what you have. You must have heard from your parents and teacher that feel satisfied, you know, whatever you have, you should be content about that thing. But that is what we are, I am saying here in economics, that this is human nature not to be content about what you have, you want something different. And this property is trying to capture that particular nature of, that particular angle of human behavior, that you are not happy about what you have. You would always prefer something different, little bit different, no matter how small the change is, but in that zone also you would prefer something else over the original bundle. Now, the funny part is that when you get what you prefer and you take a small zone around the new bundle, again you will have something. So, basically what we are talking about is mirage, that you are not happy about what you have, you are trying to search for another bundle and no matter how, you know, no matter how small zone you consider, you will always have another bundle in your mind that you would say that you prefer over the original bundle. I am not saying that all the bundles, one bundle, at least there will be one bundle in that zone that you would prefer over the original bundle. So, first one says more is better, second one says that you are not happy about what you have. Which one do you think is more stringent? Or let me put in another way, that do you think non-satiation would imply monotonicity or monotonicity will imply non-satiation? Or they are quite different, they are very different. Think about it. Are they very different, or one implies the other, or they are the same, that if they are the same, it means that one implies the other and the second one implies the first one. Which one is the case? No? They are the same? Okay. Let me ask you this. Go with the example that we have in the class. This is the indifference curve, it is moving in this direction, okay? It means the utility is increasing in this direction. Here we have good 1, here we have good 2. Does it satisfy monotonicity? Or local non-satiation? Or both are satisfied? Think about it. This is very simple. Of course, monotonicity is not satisfied. What does it say? Less is better. And monotonicity is just reverse, that more is better. So, of course, monotonicity is not satisfied. How about local non-satiation? It is satisfied at all point except at 0 comma 0, except at 0 comma 0. Take any bundle here and take a small neighborhood. And if you move in this direction, of course, you will find a bundle that you prefer more over the original bundle. So, what we are saying, we are not talking about direction. We are talking about that any small neighborhood that we take, and we are able to find a bundle that is preferred over original bundle. And if that happens, local non-satiation is satisfied. But come to 0 now. What is happening at 0? Of course, we will not get the whole circle because this part is not in the conjunction zone, conjunction set. So, we will consider only small sector. And what is happening in that sector? We cannot find any bundle which is preferred over 0 comma 0. So, local non-satiation is not satisfied at 0 comma 0, but it is satisfied at everywhere else, fine. So, of course, monotonicity is not satisfied at any point. Local satiation is satisfied at all points except at 0 comma 0. Is it clear? So, which one is more strict requirement? Which would be violated? Monotonicity. Monotonicity will always imply local non. If monotonicity is satisfied, monotonicity implies local non-satiation. But this does not imply monotonicity, okay? Because local non-satiation does not restrict the direction that you need to move away from the original bundle. But monotonicity is clearly about a direction that you will have to move in the, in two dimensional world, I can say that you will have to move in the north to east direction, anywhere in the north east direction. It is northeast or northwest? I'm quite poor with the direction. Northeast. So, you can, you have to move in the northeast direction to find a bundle that is preferred over original bundle. Fine? It is clear? So, this concept is clear? Okay. Now, let us talk about it. I already told you that this is, do you think non-satiation, forget about local or mono, just I am saying in general. Do you think non-satiation, do we always exhibit non-satiation property? Do we always exhibit, I am talking about real world, not a theoretical construct, I am talking about real human. No, sir. No, sir. Can you give me an example when it is violated?
Weight.
Huh? Weight? But body weight is not good, we are talking about goods, which gives, no, goods which give us pleasure if we consume food.
After certain level, we
do
not like it.
So, what we are saying that after certain level of food, our happy, if we eat more, our level of happiness will decrease. So, there is a point which gives us maximum, there is a finite point that gives us maximum satisfaction. So, non-satiation is not satisfied in that case. But if I say, let us say you are allowed to dispose of food freely, disposing, throwing food does not have any cost. Remember, right now we are talking about consumption set. So, we are not considering any cost. One way to say that we are talking about all these bundles at zero cost. So, it does not matter. So, if we go with the same theoretical construct, then if we are allowed to, you let us say disposal of food is costless, then this assumption is satisfied. We can get food and we can throw it off. Probably later on you will see that the budget constraint would kick in and food would be costly. So, if you get maximum satisfaction at such level, then you do not want to consume more. So, it is not that big a problem. Fine. So, it is clear, okay. But still it is not always the we should keep in mind that it is not always satisfied. Okay. So, when we are using the utility function which uses or indifference curve which uses concepts from non-satiation, then we need to be careful about it. Fine. We have talked about satiation, non-satiation. So, let us talk about satiation also. What is satiation? State of being satisfied. State of being satisfied. And we can consider a bundle. Let us say if our preference, if my preference exhibit this satiation property, what it means? That there exists a bundle that gives me maximum possible happiness, satisfaction, utility, okay, or satisfaction. And that bundle, a point representing that bundle is called bliss point. That is a name we use, that you are in bliss, you know, nothing can be better than this. Or nirvana point also you can call. Okay? Is it clear? And when you exhibit satiation, what typically happens? Nearer you are to the bliss point, happier you would be. So, if you are comparing two bundles, the bundle that would be closer to the bliss point, you would prefer that particular bundle. And just one more thing, because he said just 2-3 minutes. So, one more thing I should tell you going back. Now, what we have here, going back to this example, here we had k1, k2, k3, and these are the value associated with this indifference curve. And what we have is k3 is greater than k2, k2 is greater than, or k3 is in this particular case, sorry, k3 is less than k2. And k2 is less than k1, fine. And let us say the value that we have taken, k1 is equal to 1, k2 is equal to 2 and k3 is equal to 5. What we can do simply, rather than using x1 plus x2 is equal to k, what we can do? x1 plus x2 plus 5 is equal to k. Nothing will change. You will get the same indifference map. So, that is the ordinal property. Fine, done.